What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another Fishroom Friday here at the Coldwater Aquatics YouTube channel. My name is Brandon, and this is our live stream. Hopefully everything's doing good. I forgot to check the audio. Looks like it's good. Appreciate y'all for coming by, hanging out. Thank you so much. Like I said, my name is Brandon. This is my Coldwater Fishroom. 61 degrees Fahrenheit down here. None of these tanks have heaters in them. I keep almost all North American native fish, and they don't need to be warm. So my fish room comes from about 55 degrees in the winter to like 75 in the summer. And I keep a lot of sunfish. I have grass pickerel. I have a bowfin. I have grim perch, shiners, rainbow shiners. I have darters. I got all kinds of cool stuff. So this is our weekly live stream. We get down here, hang out with you guys in the chat, say what's up with everybody, talk some fish. And then I also have some shrimp that I will bust out, and we'll go around and do a little feeding. So a little different angle too this week. If you notice, if you come by here and you hang out week after week, you're gonna say, what's going on with this angle? But we're over here, like in the, you know, this would have been about where this tank used to sit, about right here. So we bumped it over, we turned it, it came here, we put it over here, we made some more room, we get the back up, and then we get all kinds of different views. So you can see this is the metal frame. Here's a 125. This is a 90 over here. And then this, you can barely see a sliver of it. That's the 150. So, yeah, a little different view. That's one thing that's changed, I guess, down here. And the other thing that's changed is I've got these tanks set up here, too. So let me see if I can bring this other camera in and show you guys. Set up another 75-40 combo stand and tanks right here. And if you've seen the video where we went to Tropical Magic and Killy Carnival, you'll see that we got a bunch of plants. And I need to change this. I need to change this camera here. Hang on a second. I'm trying to adjust the camera. But anyways, we got a bunch of plants, and I set them up in these tanks. So I did record all that. I haven't put the video out yet because I'm still working on it, as you would say, I guess. There we go. And it's muted. Is it muted? Hopefully. Let's bring it in here. Yeah. And switcheroo-ski. Okay, there we go. A little bit low on the angle too. All right. Yeah, so that's the tanks right back here behind me. I used play sand in them, and it's taken like 3 days to get them this clear. So I've been cleaning the filter. I think I cleaned the filters out twice. I put some old aquarium filters in them, but I haven't really like super seeded them yet. But I've had to clean the filters out like two times, and it's just bringing basically silt and dust like from the play sand out. So, but yeah, did that this week, set those two tanks up, and I'm gonna pretty confident I'm gonna move Bo Cephas from the tank next over to the 75. So that'll give him a bigger tank, and he's a warm mouth. He's gonna get big, give him plenty of room to grow. And then on the bottom tank down there, I'm gonna use rainbow shiners for that. So I'm gonna put my bunch of rainbow shiners in there. And then I might actually do some more stuff and move some more things around in the fish room. So yeah, that's what we did. That's what we did this week. Let me get to the chat so I don't miss nothing here from you guys. Carol Cox is here. What's up, Carol? Nice to see you. Metalhead, nice to see you, brother. How are you? John McKenzie, 3G in the house. Saline Aquatics, what is up with all y'all wonderful people? Go with the Flow Aquatics, welcome. Select Pet, Too Cooley for Schoolie, nice to see you. How you been? Don't forget to like. We appreciate that. Aquatic Ness in the house, my wonderful wife. Thank you so much for being here, guys. Make sure you're subscribed to all these fabulous people. Bunny Viper, welcome, welcome. Yes, yes, yes. Nice. You guys are all just conversating back and forth. Very good, very good. Saline Aquatic says, the wife and kids have a funeral to go to up in PA where we are from. I have a step behind, so a week without the wife means adding 2 20-gallon longs into the fish room. Well, there you go, buddy. That's one way to do it. What's up, fish fam? Kenny from ABC Aquatic Biotope Creations. How you doing, buddy? QC with the links. Thank you, brother. Making it easy for you guys. Click in the comments. See the person. See the link. Go over there to see. Are you subscribed? Maybe you were. Maybe you thought you were, but you're not. Hey or nah. All right, man. Appreciate you, Matt. Thanks for coming, brother. How are you? Hope you're doing good. I'm approaching 6.3K subs, Brandon. After I hit 1K, I took off. That is awesome, man. Congratulations, brother. That's good seeing you grow. That's cool. Whatever you're doing, you must be doing the right thing, man. Heck yeah. Thank you so much, QC, for dropping the links. Appreciate all you guys. Yeah. Let's do weather check. Kenny's lurking and feeding the baby. All right. What's the weather in your guys' neck of the woods? 54 degrees and sunny here in northern Indiana. Let us know in the comments. Even if this is down the road, let us know. I'm drinking some nice coffee. Aquatic Nest made me some nice coffee. Ready. We're ready. Oh, yes. We can feed some fish, too. I got two shrimp. I tried thawing like five or six shrimp out. I didn't get them all thawed out, but two of them did thaw out. So I got two shrimp cut up. I can feed a couple big fish, a couple small fish. And I got some blood worms and some frozen brine. So we're going to do a little bit of feeding here in a little bit. I'm sure we'll get around. We'll probably do the green sunfish and rock bass, and then we'll probably go back there and do the grass pickerels, pumpkin seed, and then obviously we're going to try to do Mr. Bojangles, the bowfin, and we'll get a few more in there too. Snowing with a foot of snow on the ground. Wow. Dang it. That's, that is what it is, I guess. Whew, man. We were out in the garden today. We got actually seen little, I'm pretty sure they're little cucumbers that are growing from rotted cucumber plants or fruit that we left out there, kind of like in the compost pile. So crazy, you guys got a foot of snow on the ground and it's snowing. 59 and sunny in near Seattle. Nice. Joey Lowell, what's up? Nice. How are you, brother? Welcome to the stream. Hope everybody's doing fabulous tonight. 44 and windy and overcast there where Kenny's at. 79 and sunny, man. That's some good life right there, brother. There's Joey's channel link, guys. Check him out. See if they got some content over there, and consider subscribing to all the people in the chat. We appreciate y'all. Build a community. We do this stream every week, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so you can come back week after week and hang out. And there's always new people here. It seems like there's always a few new people here. Put it in the chat. Put it in the comments. If this is your first time here tonight, let us know. I feel like, Joey, have you been here? Maybe. I feel like you may have been here before. But usually we pick up a few new people here and there. So let us know if that's you this week. We all want to say hi. 34 next weekend. Oh, geez. It looks like it's going to warm up here, but if it's going to be 34 where you're at, it's going to be probably colder here. That's just the physics of it. QC says, sorry I was late, got a call from a buddy who needed some tech support with his laptop. Oh man, coming in. Well, we appreciate you. Thank you for coming by, and I'm sure your buddy appreciates you for the tech support, man. That's awesome. Sunny and low 70s. Pollen's kicking his butt. Oh jeez. So all your like fruit or your fruit trees going to stuff down there, flowers, all that stuff. We're starting to get, we got a lot of buds on trees here. And grass is definitely turning green. And then we got a lot of, maybe they're daffodils or lilies or something like that. They're outside perennials that are flowered already. This, you know, it's not even April yet. So, seems early. Probably some die-off may happen, huh? Some things may suffer if it gets cold. Oklahoma 74, 53 low. Oh, Saline Aquatics, first time. Well, guys, make sure you go over there and make sure you subscribe to Saline Aquatics. First time coming by. Oh, yeah. I appreciate your comedy, man. That's good. That's good stuff. Yeah, send that warm weather our ways. Absolutely. Otter Pools, what's up? I want me a Bojangle so bad. Sucks I can't order one for myself. Are you overseas? Are you not in the U.S.? Because I think Jonah might still have some available at jonahsquarium.com. I'm not positive on that, but oh, QC, but look at all these jokesters. You guys are just coming out of the woodwork. QC's first time as well. Well, that's just so special. Welcome, brother. Nice to meet you. I feel like we're going to have a wonderful relationship. Joey has a question. Do you know if there are any gobies in the cold rivers here in Oregon, as I think I have found some? That's a good question. I do not know that. I do not know much of the native fish of Oregon. That sounds like a cold place. Maybe they're gobies. Maybe there's something that looks similar like a goby, like a sculpin. I would say you could mistake a sculpin for a goby. And sculpin are in very cold climates. But what I would recommend, nanfa.org. QC probably dropped the link already. Click on nanfa.org or fish map. Is it fish map? Fishmap.org. Go to fishmap.org. You can put in your zip code, and then it'll look up your whole watershed or the waterways around your area and tell you pretty much the standard species you're going to find in that area. And it breaks it down with all the links from like Wikipedia to Google, and you can see pictures and all that stuff. So check it out. That would be my recommendation. If you're out there finding some fish and you think there's something, you don't know what they are, fishmap.org, look them up, put your zip code in, go through the Google pictures, and you'll probably figure it out. Otter Pools, awesome. First time live for me. That's cool, man. Appreciate you for coming. Thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it. Have I been here before? I don't know. Select Pet, have you? I don't know. It's so hard to tell. Definitely not been here and picking killie eggs at the same time before. Probably not. Yes, Joey, there are some invasive goby. Okay, there you go. From like ballast water and ships and stuff from overseas. What are they? I know around here in the Great Lakes we got the round goby. Yep. That could make sense too, yeah. Could be an invasive one. In the 80s here in Southwest Florida. Whoa, that's warm. Nice. Asian something. Yeah. Okay. Yes, I've been here before, and that's not my channel. It's QC Aquaholics channel. Ah. Well, I'm sorry. But I'm sure your channel got dropped. I'm sure it did. Right? Let's see. QC Aquaholics. Yeah, it's right there. That's your channel, ain't it? QC got that. Outer Pools link. Coral, what's up, brother? How are you? First time here as well. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you too, brother. How are you? How you been? I'm sure you've been good. No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. We'll give a mod first time. Definitely not. Oh, yeah. Kenny, what's your favorite pleco? What's your favorite pleco? We have a lot of sculpin too, though. Yeah, I'm sure you do. Paul McCarthy, howdy, brother. How you doing? Everything says out of stock for me, but love your channel and tanks. Keep it up, man. All right. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. And thanks for coming by. Thanks for hopping out and saying what's up in the chat. It's nice to meet you new people that come by here week after week. A lot of y'all come back. You're like the regulars, but we get some new people, so it's cool to see. It's cool to see you. There's Paul McCarthy's link. Sailing Aquatic dropping my 2024 fish room tour. Check it out, guys. That was a good video. I was happy with that video. I had a good time making that video. I'm going to try to have more fun making more videos. So I've been trying to get a good feeding video with the new fish, but they're not cooperating. What did you get, man? Have you not put a video up? Have you only put that picture up? Because that picture, I swore, I'm like, that looks like a pickerel. But it also could be a couple other things. Possibly. Something smaller, maybe. Joey says, no, I have no channel, bro. I'm just a watcher. Okay, man. Well, hey, you might get some subscribers now. They never do. Yeah, they never do. That's true. What's your best native algae-eating fish? I don't have one, really. I don't think. Yeah. I don't think anybody really eats any algae. I couldn't tell you anything. Probably my best algae eating is that happens in the fish room is probably snails. But yeah, I don't have a lot of algae eating, and that's why I have so much. And I deal with it on the glass, and then everywhere else I pretty much let it go. So if you can see, you know, you see like on this big root ball back here, it's just covered in algae. That's just what it is. Yeah, can't think of anyone that actually eats it. I've heard, what is it? I thought it was a dace or something like that, maybe. But I don't know. Haven't had it happen yet with any native fish. Good question, though. Finding something they would eat has been a chore, too. Ah, Blue Bounty. There's their link. Check them out. They're red fins. Ah, nice. So, what have you been trying to feed them? Worms, they would probably be all about worms, wouldn't they? How big? And they're probably what? They're about, yay, about 4 inches, 3-4 inches? I would try to feed them shrimp, but that's just because I like feeding the shrimp. You need to email Mark at Jonah's Aquarium for an updated stock list. Yeah, definitely. Don't go by like what his website says. It's best to try to get a hold of him or get on his Facebook even. Get on his Facebook page, jonasaquarium.com, and he puts his cell phone number. You can actually text him and stuff like that. So definitely. Big Steve, hello, hello, hello. Flagfish, maybe that was what I had heard. Flagfish, yeah. Good job, Kenny. There you go. Algae-eating native fish, flagfish. Florida flagfish. What are they? What do they consider those little fish? Pupfish, something like that, right? Joey says, I love your tanks, bro. They're all so cool. Well, thank you, man. I appreciate that. I really do. I've been doing these fish tanks down here for a long time, and they haven't always looked cool. And some of them have looked cooler, but I just keep doing it. And, yeah, it's all pretty natural. It's all pretty natural. Florida flagfish will eat hair algae. There you go. Hashtag white sucker. Hashtag white sucker. I do like my white sucker. I don't think he eats algae, though. Be cool if he did. I love the algae stump. Oh, we'll have to get over there and show it then. You have any central stone rollers, algae eater? I do not. I do not have any central stone rollers. I think I had one at one time, but he didn't do that well. He was a little antsy, like real darty. And I think he kind of burned himself out. I've tried thin strips of tilapia first. I looked at them, but didn't go for it until after I gave up recording them. Okay. Are you like tweezering it or landscape tonging it and enticing them? Cut it in little long little strips, kind of make it have like a little bit of motion. But yeah, that's what I've done with little pickerel. You really gotta feed them too. You gotta stay on a little pickerel, get them growing up. Seem like they require quite a bit of food. But yeah, I would try some raw shrimp, man. Cut it in little strips, and then obviously you could do worms, or if you wanted to do some little feeders. But that probably a little pickerel probably eat you out of feeders real quick. Unless you had nowhere you could catch like a bunch of mosquito fish or something. J-Rock does stuff. Hey, Maple, hope you're good. We finished the rain barrel system for the house this week. The barrels will hold old fish water too. That's awesome, J-Rock. You really do stuff, don't you, man? That's so cool. Thanks for coming by. I appreciate you, buddy. One of them did finally eat something. Nice. Was it so it ate some of the tilapia that you were feeding it? There's J-Rock's link, guys. Check him out. Joey says, if you add a bit of aquarium salt, you will have no algae. I have two tanks with live plants, Endlers, guppies, corys, and are all doing fine. Well, that's cool, man. Good advice. But yeah, I don't really use much of the aquarium salt. I'm more El Natural. I just sort of let her go. Collaboration of Curiosity with the $2 Australian Super Chat. Happy Easter, Ice Cubes. Well, happy Easter to you, too. And happy Easter to everybody in the chat coming up here. Whether it's tomorrow or then Sunday for you, whatever day it is. If you celebrate that. Oh, I spilled my little coffee cup just a little bit. Dang it. That's all right, though. But thank you so much for the Super Chat. I do appreciate that. And I hope you have a wonderful day. Fish Fam Links, thanking Adele for the Super Chat as well. Very cool. And there is her link over there to Collaboration of Curiosities. Very neat. He is quick. He's got technology on his side. That's for sure. The LFS said they were feeding them blackworms and feeder fish. That makes sense. That's cool then that your LFS had them. Wow.
I'm not doing the feeders, and everyone has been out of black worms.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't blame you on not wanting to do the feeder, especially from the LFS. That would be bad. Yeah. I got some mealworms, and they did attack them, but spit them right back out. Man, I'm still leaning on the shrimp. That's what I'd be trying. Oh, I'm just Legacy. What's up, Melvin? How you doing, brother? Good to see you. Welcome, welcome. There's his link, guys. Make sure you're subscribed. Check him out. Hit the like button, absolutely. I tried some shrimp too, but they wouldn't go for it. Man. Have you tried worms? Have you tried worms? Because you could do worms, but worms aren't the most nutritious. You could try. I don't know if you can get like spikes and stuff like that either down there, but do you guys have like stuff like that? Spikes or bee moss? Which, I mean, I don't know. I've caught pickerel on bee moss before. So, Jim's Fish, what's up? How you doing? Welcome to the stream. Brandon got so excited. I spilled just a dribble. I got just a little dribble. It's not bad. But, hey, it had the lid on it, so it just came out the little hole there. Yeah, and she gave me a lid. So, she definitely done her part. Like, she has definitely done her part to take care of me, and I have fooled this up myself. I did get some red wigglers, and they did eat two of them. That was overnight, though. Really? They didn't eat them in front of you. Maybe they're not hungry enough. That's surprising. What kind of a you got them in a tank with any other fish, or are they on their own? They're only about 3 or 3.5 inches. Oh, they're small then. Yeah, I've done kept little ones like that. Yeah, I got him on shrimp. He was eating shrimp. I don't know if I'd ever raised him completely up though, but I got him quite a bit larger than that. He was about that size, I feel like. Jeff Kane, what's up, brother? How are you? Welcome, welcome. There's Jeff's link, guys. Make sure you go over there and check him out. Make sure you're subscribed. Definitely. They are very personable, though. When I walk up to the tank, one of them usually swims up to me. That's awesome, man. So that to me makes me feel like you definitely could get them to eat the shrimp. Or what you would want to do, what I think you would want to do is to get them to eat, like, maybe you could get them on pellets. I don't know. Some people say they get their pickerel on pellets. I think that would be an awesome idea. No, nutritionally, you know, it would probably be great, but if you can make it happen, that's a different story. I would try to get them on, like, some nice protein where you can get quite a bit of nutrition in them, and fish fillets, shrimp, maybe go out and catch a couple bluegill and fillet a couple bluegill, try some, you know, fresh fish fillets. I don't know. So, obviously, worms, if you can get them to eat worms. I'm sure you can get it figured out, or maybe they'll eat like some bug bite things or something. I don't know. Every pickerel I've had and have had success with and feeding has always been feeding them with tongs and feeding them some, like, you know, high protein raw food, raw meat, but basically shellfish. I fed them fish too. I've tried beef liver too. The big pickerel has eaten beef liver, and it's got quite a smell to it. Something else to think about. I would love to come and visit and see your fish room when I get a bigger place. I am setting up a 195-gallon tank and will have cold water fish in it, as they are very fun. I agree. They are very fun. Yep, they are. I like it because it's cold down here in my fish room. It works out well. I don't have to run any heaters. It's not inefficient. It's nice and cheap and, yeah. I definitely enjoy the fish, and I like to fish too. I'm a fisherman, so I go out. I got kayaks, we got a canoe, we got a boat. We go out and spend quite a bit of time in the water in the summertime. So I like to see the fish, and then to be able to keep some of the same fish that I can go out and catch in my local area, and, you know, It's cool. It's like bringing some nature into your house a little bit, and pretty connected within my hobby of, you know, the fish keeping and the actual going out and angling, I guess you would say. I thought you didn't drink coffee. When did you think I didn't drink coffee? I mean, I didn't drink coffee like a year ago or more, maybe, for a while, but then I started drinking coffee again. They're a 20 long by themselves. Nice. And how many did you get? A couple of them? Brandon has a lid fired up, bro. I do, man. I do got a lid. I don't know. Fired up. I don't know. Or maybe we're not talking about the same lid. There's Jim Fish's link, guys. Check him out. Does the microphone sound any different this week? I put the poofy thing on it. Poof. The poof. Poofy thing. Does it sound any better? Craig's Catfish Cave. What's going on with you, buddy? Appreciate you for being here. There's his link. In case you didn't know it, go over there and make sure you're subscribed. I have a feeling it's going to take a few months to train them. I feel like you're probably right. They've only have live foods up till now. So yeah, you're probably going to have a little struggle then. Dave Jones, what's up, buddy? How you doing? There's his link, guys. Check him out. Make sure you're subscribed. Yep. Does anyone know what kind of gobies would be in the rivers of Oregon? I think Coral referred to some invasive gobies that have came over in the ballast water of some ships, probably from Asia. So I don't know. I would recommend going to fishmap.org. Okay. Do it. QC, are you doing the work? QC's going to do the work. What's the zip code? He's going to figure it out for you. Stand by. Stand by, Joey. Will we get results? QC's on the job. F. Is that supposed to be F like Jeff, like if? Whips World, what's up with you? Let's get tanked. Poofy thing. Nice. Joy, iNaturalist might be a source as well as your state's fish and game website. Let's do something fun. Paul McCarthy, new member. Welcome back, brother. Thank you so much. Can we share the screen? No, let's see. Do I got to pull up another browser up? There we go. Let me get fishmap.org up here. We're going to do this together. Okay. Present, right? Yeah, present, share screen. Fishmap.org, share. Okay, can you see it? There we go. All right. Okay, here we are. And with the zip code. The zip code was 97301. Fishmap.org. Bam, right here. 97301. Oh, you know what? It's probably not going to tell us the invasives, is it? And here you go. Over there by Portland. Chinook salmon. Oh, now you're going to get all the cutthroat, mountain sucker, long-nosed dace, mountain whitefish, northern pike minnow. Oh, let's look at that. Northern pike minnow. Really? Man, kind of sporty minnow. Do I close this? Yeah. Okay. Are we not? It did not go. Why? What is it? What is going on? Let's try it again. Let me remove this. Can I remove this? This, yeah. There? Screen. Add screen. Fishmap.org. Why is it not updating? okay, let me try this then. I guess I can't figure this out. What the heck? Share screen, fishmap.org. Share. Can see that? Okay, can see that. What, 97301? 97301. Find. Now you can see it. Okay, here we go. So, like I was saying, salmon, chiselmouth salmon, cutthroat, longnose dace, mountain sucker. Oh, here we go. Pacific lamprey. Peyote sculpin? Peyote? Any of these look familiar there, brother? Are we still at the screen? We're not at the screen. Anyways, the sculpin there, those look really, a prickly sculpin too. It brings up a new link, so I feel like the share is not going over. I know, man. I'm just curious as myself as to what kind of fish he's talking about, maybe. And a reticulated sculpin. And a torrent sculpin. Holy smokes. So right there you go. You got four sculpin in your watershed. That's pretty impressive for little sculpin in freshwater. Pretty cool. Let's, where are we at? 635. Let's bring another camera back since I closed it. And let's do some feeding. Feed some of these fish. Uh-huh. settings. Gotta change the camera. And the audio. Turn the audio down. There we go. Happy Easter, Craig. Yep. Fish Fam link. I'm going to play with the fish map a little. It's cool, man. Check it out. Big Easy, what's up with you, brother? How you doing? Oh, you already did it. All right. You already did what? Did you go and look? Did you know there's four sculpin over there? I apologize if I miss anybody. You put the link in the chat. I know you did. Day off. Nice. Very nice. All right. Let's go feed some fish. Let's do that. All right. We'll do the pickerel first. Grass pickerel and the pumpkin seed. Cooperating, are you? There you go. Took a minute. Didn't know what he was doing there. He has a little trouble with reflection. Reflection is his enemy. Yes, happy Easter to everybody. Hope you all have a wonderful weekend. There's the old grass pickerel and the 125. A little dingy looking, not terrible. with the pumpkin seed sunfish in there. And now we're going to move over to... we're going to move over to Mr. Bojangles. We're going to do that. Thank you, Melvin. I appreciate that, brother. Tell you what, man, I'm sunfish.
They are hogs. He's gonna eat out. He's gonna eat the other piece. He's thinking about it. Are you serious? Jeez. Goodness gracious.
I tell you what, sunfish, they're hogs. They are just big time hogs. Could we see you feed earthworms to the bigger fish sometimes? Yeah, I will. I definitely will. I need to get some. I don't have any right now, but I definitely will. I don't do that a lot. Some people get a little butthurt over the worms getting ate, but I don't feel like it's that big a deal. So yeah, I do. I just haven't done it in a while. I'll do it randomly, like I just did it in my last, like 2 days ago. I went out and got some dirt when I was setting these tanks up over here, and I found a worm in one. I threw it in the tank. I do that when I'm out gardening. If we're out doing stuff and we get a handful of worms or a cup full of worms, we'll bring them down here, throw them in. But yeah, I definitely will. Come back next week, Dave. We'll do it next week. How about that? I'll try to remember, try to get some worms this week. We'll do that. Absolutely. How often do you change your airstone in your sponge filter? I don't change them. These sponge filters don't have airstones. This one, the one big one in this tank that's not even working at the moment, I just have an empty, like the line comes down in it, and then I just leave the end off the line. But what happens, and probably what's happened now, is it builds up like hard water deposits and quits running. So, but no, I use the little, I don't have any, the black ones. The black four or five inch sponge filters. I buy them on Amazon on the old jungle website for like $5 a piece, I think. And I don't have to clean. You don't have the sponge. They don't have a stone in them or anything. But they have the little holes in the bottom diffuser that get built up too. You got to go in there and clean them out here every once in a while. Yep. Does anyone have a favorite airstone, or do y'all just use whatever? I don't use any. I don't really use airstones. No problem. I like aquarium co-op airstone. There you go. I have some black ones that I've got in like a little kit with airline, but yeah, I really don't use airstones. All right, let's feed these guys. Get it, Bubba.
There you go.
Get it.
He's going to get that now. He's going to let it hit the bottom. This is a 75-gallon metal frame tank here. Oh, he got it. The big old chunk of brine. That sunfish at the bottom is a dollar sunfish. There's a rainbow darter right below it, too. And then middle of the tank, black-sided darter. A couple of eastern mosquito fish there throughout. And then there's also some central mud minnows in here, as well as a white sucker. There's a blunt-nosed minnow in there. Why does it look so... The tank usually has more activity, but there's a blunt-nosed minnow that's usually always swimming around. And I think that's about it. Oh, there's a mud minnow up towards the middle, kind of hanging on the driftwood. But yeah, that's a little maple tree root ball. LFS had some dollar sunfish too, but I didn't get any. Man, that's awesome, dude. That's cool. The ones I have do have airstones in them. Okay. They are round and blue. Ah, I see. The airstones I have are black, but yeah, I don't know. I think the ones that QC's talking about maybe are the ZIS adjustable, or I feel like you can buy some fancy airstones that like have serviceability, right? Like you can take them apart and clean them or something, as opposed to like the little rock ones that just break. Aqua New Grow, what is up? Welcome, welcome. Smurfy Good Times, howdy, folks. Well, hello, Smurfy Good Times. Howdy, howdy. You should see the pumpkin seeds we have here in Oregon. They are beautiful gems. Should I send you one? That's awesome. I'm sure they are pretty. We have some pretty nice ones here, too. I got pumpkin head. He's a pumpkin seed. And then I got another pumpkin seed, too. We'll move over to that tank here in a minute. That little mud minnow came out. There's the blunt nose there in the bottom, right? Or is that the sucker? Yeah, that's the blunt nose. God, he's moving so slow. Kind of hiding. For shiners, they had rainbows, Bama blue rainbows, satin fin, and iron color. Wow, dude. That's awesome. That's awesome that you can get a selection like that. Mountain red belly dace, golden top minnows. Nice. Rainbow and fantail darters, hell yeah. The boats are starting, all right. Start them engines. redfin pickerel, chain pickerel, wow. Seminole killifish, holy smokes, dude. Is this like a Nanfa fish room, fish store? That's freaking awesome, man. That's cool. Ellisoma Evergladi. Very cool. All right, let's move the camera. We're going to pop over to the 90-gallon that has a pumpkin seed, yellow perch, and two common shiners in it. The owner just likes natives. That's awesome, dude. That's very awesome. All right. We'll do a little spin around the fish room for you guys. So if it's your first time here, this is what it looks like right here. 75-40 right there. Yellow bullhead. Gymno geophagus down there. Metal frame 75. Little species of rainbow shiners down here. Rainbow shiners. Dirty tank. 125 right here, grass pickerel, red eared sunfish, 90 gallon, pumpkin seed, perch, common shiners, 40 breeder, wargill, 150, bowfin, pumpkin seed, and then got some rice fish in there with some white cloud mountain minnows, some gadeids. Warm mouth. Then the two new tanks that I just set up this week right there around the corner. 6 foot tank right there, and then that dude over there, a little 55 gallon. So yeah. Where are we going? We're going over here.
tipsy. A little tipsy.
Oh yeah, shiners, freaking big old shiners or hogs too. Tell you what, my pants are almost dry. The rain has gone for races day. Nice. I have seen some huge yellow perch. Yeah, some yellow perch. Yellow perch get big. They get like walleye size almost. Every time I go in, I asked who they got their natives from, but all the employees don't know. The boss does the ordering, and he isn't on the weekends usually. Yeah, we don't know. We don't know. Probably the best thing to say. I'm sure there's ways. There's ways to do it. Depends. Every state's different, and all it takes is a little bit of permitting. Normally, even in some states that are pretty restrictive, you can get it figured out. So, very cool. All right, guys. I think we're coming down to an end. What do you got? Oh, you got some. Oh, you got some worms. You got some worms. Aquatic Nuts went out and caught some worms. Seriously? Like out under rocks and stuff?
Yeah.
You look like, guys. Aquatic Nuts just went out and caught some worms under some rocks. Was that? That was Dave, right? You wanted to see that? Yeah. Yeah. Okay, Dave. Put it in the chat, Dave. We got worms here. What do you want to see? Eat the worms. Because they'll all eat them. So let me know. Let me know. Yeah. Coral says thank you. Thanks, Ness. I doubt they get them from Jonah's because their prices are... Yeah, they don't get them from Jonah's. You couldn't... I don't think you could... you know, you'd have a hard time making money buying from Jonah's and trying to resell. I'm sure he gets them much cheaper. I'm not eating one, no. Wow, above and beyond. Pickerel. Okay.
Pickerel. Above and beyond is right. That is absolutely right. Okay. Come here. Sonny. Ready. Red. Oh, it was off camera. I was hoping Red would come. Okay. Over here. You see that one? Should have seen that one. Oh, he's got it hanging out of his mouth.
Missed that one. Camera angle was a little sideways.
Was it?
That's why QC's.
He's got it hanging out of his mouth still.
Alright, I'm going upstairs, wash my hands. Okay. They're nasty.
Thank you.
Digging in the dirt for your stream.
Alright, let's see if we can get another one here. Missed that one too. Oh, he got part of it. He got most of it. He's getting them. Hanging out his mouth too. had enough. There you go.
Any left for both in? Okay.
Yeah, we do that. Maybe. George Angles, you gonna stay out, brother? Scaredy. He's eating your words, brother. No,
Mr. Bojangles did want nothing to do with that. He let Pumpkinhead eat them all. He was right there. He ran. He was fraidy. Yeah, it will, man. You keep feeding them. It just takes time. It just takes time. They got to get hungry too. He is a dummy. Yeah, he's not you know, you can take the elite of the elite from their environment and put them in something different, and they're definitely going to have issues. So in the wild, I'm sure he was much more of a savage fish with his attacks than he is in a fish tank. But, you know, that's what happens. You put a creature behind a piece of glass and the reflection even confuses it, so. Yeah, and you missed it with the camera angle. There you go. Yeah, that's okay. I'm trying to make you happy, brother. I'm trying. Sunfish are garbage disposals with fins. They are. They pretty much are. That's a good description of a sunfish. Absolutely. Alright. I think that's going to do it for the stream tonight, guys. I appreciate y'all for coming and hanging out. Hopefully y'all had a good time. Made some things happen. Aquatic Nest went out and got some worms. Very cool. And, yeah. Told you guys on the updates. We checked the weather. All that good stuff. We're going to run the numbers appreciation video again. Is it going? Is it going? Peace out, guys. See you next time.